Hello everyone, I am Prabhu Venmaral, Assistant Professor, Department of CSE, BIDCET, Vijaypur. In this video, I am going to discuss about statistical models in simulation. So the following are the topics I am going to discuss in this video, that is probability, discrete random variable, continuous random variable, expectation, dispersion, and more. So the probability is the measure of the chance. So according to the Laplace classical definition, the probability of an event is defined a priori without actual experimentation as given below. That is, probability of A equal to number of the outcomes favorable to A divided by total number of the possible outcomes. Discrete random variable. X is discrete random variable if the number of the possible values of X is finite or countably infinite. So let us consider an example. Consider a job arriving at a job shop. Let X be a number of the jobs arriving each week at job shop, and Rx is the possible values of X. So it could be what here, 0, 1, 2, and so on. So the probability of Xi is given by, that is, P of X equal to Xi. So the probability of arriving a job has to be selected from any one of this range space itself. So the probability of getting one is nothing but what here, the discrete random variable, right? So the possible values of the job arriving can be selected from anyone from the range space itself, right? So it is all the values are what here, defined. So there is no range, discrete values are present in a range space, and it must satisfy the following properties: the probability of getting 0, 1, 2, so on has to satisfy the following properties. That is, probability of Xi should be what here, greater than or equal to 0 for all the value of I, and the summation of the probabilities value should be equal to what here, 1. So the collection of the pair Xi and Pxi, nothing but probability of Xi, where I equal to 1, 2, so on, is called as probability distribution of Xi, and probability of Xi is called as what here, probability mass function. So let us consider an example. Consider the experiment of tossing a single die. So define X as a number of the spots on up space of the die. After tossing, so the die may land up as what here, 1, 2, 3, so on up to what here, 6. Assume the die is landed so that the probability that a given face land up is given as follows here. So the probability of getting 1 is 1 divided by 21. The probability of getting 2 is, that is, 2 divided by 21, and so on. The probability of getting 6 is, that is, 6 divided by 21. Okay, so we can see the conditions stated earlier are going to satisfy here. That is, probability of Xi is what here, greater than 0. Say for example, the probability of 1 getting 1 is 1 divided by 21. So this is what here, greater than or equal to 0. The probability of getting 2 is, that is, 2 divided by 21. This is also greater than what here, 0. Right, and the summation of all the probabilities where I is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on, right? So that is 1 divided by 21 plus 1, 2 divided by 21, so on, 6 divided by 21. This is equal to what here, 1. So next we'll see the continuous random variable. So X is a continuous random variable if its range space Rx is an interval or a collection of the intervals, right? So the probability of getting the value, the probability of getting x, suppose if it lies between the interval, then that is called as what here? Continuous random variable. That random variable is called as continuous random variable. And the probability density function is defined as follows. That is the probability of x, it is what here? Greater than or equal to a and less than or equal to b. This is given as integration of a to b function of x dx. Okay, and it has to satisfy the following properties. So cumulative distribution function, the cumulative distribution function is denoted by capital F of x. So it measures the probability that the random variable x is less than or equal to x here, right? For a discrete random variable, the cumulative distribution function is given as, that is p of summation, so that is summation xi less than or equal to x, for all xi less than or equal to x, so p of xi, that is probability of xi. So summation of the probabilities of all xi, so where xi less than or equal to x. And in case of the continuous random variable, the cumulative function is given as, that is integration of minus infinity to x function of t dt. Let us consider an example. The cumulative distribution function for tossing a die, see, this is what here, this is the value of a and this is the value of b, right? So the cumulative distribution function for this particular range is how much here? Zero. And for the when the value of a has a 1 and value of b has a 2, the cumulative distribution function is 1 divided by 21, right? So we choose the value of x, so which is the value of xi, so which is less than or equal to what here? X here. Okay, so this x is greater than or equal to a and less than or equal to b, right? So sorry, less than b here. Right, we don't consider the probability of 2. Okay, so we consider just the probability of 0 and 1 here. Okay, the probability of 0 and 1 is nothing but 1. So in this case, the probability of 2 is nothing but 1 and 2. The probability of 1 plus the probability of 2 is nothing but what here? 2 here. So on it will be computed. The expectation, yes, if x is a random variable, then the expected value of x denoted by ex for a discrete and continuous random variables is defined as follows. So the expectation in case of discrete random variable is calculated by using this equation. That is, for all i summation xi probability of xi. And in case of the continuous random variable, the expectation is calculated as integration of minus infinity to infinity x f of x dx. The measure of the dispersion or variance. So the variance of a random variable is denoted by Vx, Varx and sigma square. So this is calculated by using this particular equation, right? So the mean Ex is measure of the central tendency of the random variable. So the variance of the X measures the expected value of the squared difference between the random variable and its mean. And the variance Vx is a measure of spread or variations of possible values of x around the mean Ex. So this is also defined as what here? Standard deviation. And mode. So in a discrete random variable case, the mode is the value of the random variable that occurs most frequently. That is the number of the times the particular number has been occurred. That is highest number of the times the particular number has been occurred. So that is considered as a mode. So in a continuous random variable case, the mode is the value at which probability density function is maximized. So if the model value of occurs at two values of a random variable, then it is said to be bimodal. Let us consider an example. So these are what here the list of the random numbers. The mode is 6 because see the 3 has occurred 2 times. Okay, and the 5 has occurred 1 time. The 6 random variable has occurred 3 times. And the 9 has occurred 2 times. So the number 6 has been occurred maximum number of times. So therefore the mode is how much here? 6. Thank you. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to see more videos on system modeling and simulation.